We are not youth any longer. We don't want to take the world by storm. We are fleeing. We fly from ourselves. From our life. We were 18 and had begun to love life and the world, and we had to shoot it to pieces. He fell in October 1918, on a day that was so quiet and still on the whole front, that the army report confined itself to the single sentence, "All quiet on the Western Front." I am very quiet. Let the months and years come, they can take nothing from me, they can take nothing more. I am so alone, and so without hope that I can confront them without fear. I believe in such cartography, to be marked by nature, not just label ourselves on a map like the names of rich men and women on buildings. We are communal histories, communal books. That's what libraries are, communal books. That's what this country is, a communal book. Our fates intertwined. Our stories together. A communal history. We are not owned or monogamous in our taste or experience. In 3 years of war, I had learned that there was not much sense in planning. The only thing was to be quick, move fast, and strike hard when you had the chance, but never wait. I am young, I am 20 years old, yet I know nothing of life but despair, death, fear, and fatuous superficiality cast over an abyss of sorrow. I see how peoples are set against one another, and in silence, unknowingly, foolishly, obediently, innocently slay one another. While they continued to write and talk, we saw the wounded and dying. While they taught that duty to one's country is the greatest thing, we already knew that death throes are stronger. We loved our country as much as they, we went courageously into every action, but also we distinguished the false from true, we had suddenly learned to see. We often made fun of them and played jokes on them, but in our hearts we trusted them. The idea of authority, which they represented, was associated in our minds with a greater insight and a more humane wisdom. But the first death we saw shattered this belief. We had to recognize that our generation was more to be trusted than theirs. They surpassed us only in phrases and cleverness. The first bombardment showed us our mistake, and under it the world as they had taught it to us broke in pieces. We have lost all feeling for one another. We can hardly control ourselves when our glance lights on the form of some other man. We are insensible, dead men, who through some trick, some dreadful magic, are still able to run and to kill. We always see it too late. Why do they never tell us that you are poor devils like us, that your mothers are just as anxious as ours, and that we have the same fear of death? We are not youth any longer. We don't want to take the world by storm. We are fleeing. We fly from ourselves. From our life. We were 18 and had begun to love life and the world, and we had to shoot it to pieces. My heart beats fast. This is the aim, the great, the sole aim, that I have thought of in the trenches, that I have looked for as the only possibility of existence after this annihilation of all human feeling.